So another force that we commonly encounter in nature is that of friction. And the purpose of friction is really to oppose motion, to stop things from moving. And there are two different kinds, two different manifestations of friction that we'll usually talk about in an introductory physics course. We have static friction, which is friction when you're not moving. We denote this with the letter F sub S, where S stands for static. And that's equal to the coefficient of static friction, mu s, times the normal force. And this is a larger amount of friction. Versus kinetic friction, which is friction due to motion, when you're in motion. And the force of kinetic friction is mu k times the normal force, the coefficient of kinetic friction times the normal. And this is a bit smaller than the static friction. So the way that I think about this is when I'm trying to move a box. When I first start trying to move a box, it's really, really hard to get it started. That's because static friction is big. Versus when once I get it moving, once I start sliding a box, it becomes much easier to actually slide it. So that's because kinetic friction is much, much smaller. So let's see an example of how we use this in some kind of problem solving. So let's take an example. So let's do an example involving friction where I have somebody skiing down a mountain. And I want to know what is the coefficient of kinetic friction that this skier experiences if their acceleration is a constant. So what I can do is I can write down some variables. Let's choose a mass for this skier. Let's say the skier is 62 kilograms. Let's say that the slope that they're skiing down is 25 degrees. And let's say that the force due to kinetic friction is equal to 45.0 newtons. Let's draw a picture of the situation so we can imagine what's going on. There's my incline, it's 25 degrees. There's my skier skiing down the hill. And we can identify all the forces acting. We have the force due to gravity. That's really what's pulling them down. So that acts straight down, and we call that the weight. And what we've seen already is when we have things on inclines, we break it into components. We break the weight into a piece that's perpendicular to the incline, that goes kind of perpendicular to this incline, W sub Y. And we have a force, a component of the weight that's parallel to the incline. And we call that W sub X. And we've seen that this angle theta, it goes right there. And we have a normal force. The normal force acts perpendicular to the incline and acts straight up. And then we have the direction of our motion, which is going to be down the incline. And we know that friction opposes motion. So friction has to act in the opposite direction. So friction is going to be acting backwards, F sub K. And this is going to be my key for solving this problem, for finding the coefficient due to friction. I know that F sub K is mu times the normal force. So I can write that down. F sub K is mu times the normal. And if I want to know mu, I can solve this equation for mu. That's going to be F sub K divided by the normal force. I know that F sub K is 45 newtons. That was a given. And then I need to divide by the normal force. So to find the normal force, I need to look at this picture. And inside of this picture, I can see some things. I can see that the normal force is going in the y direction. So let's go straight to the y direction to start solving some stuff. What's going on in this picture in the y direction? I have a sum of forces in the y direction, and that's going to be equal to the mass times the acceleration in the y direction. Well, in the y direction, am I bumping, sliding up and down and kind of bouncing up and down as I go down this incline? No, I'm not. I have no acceleration in the y direction, so that's got to be zero, which tells me that my normal force, which is acting perpendicular to the incline, minus the component of weight in the y direction, in this y direction that's perpendicular to the incline, minus Wy, has to be equal to zero. So the normal force is equal to Wy. So the normal is equal to W times cosine of theta. And we know that W is simply the mass times gravity times cosine theta. So I can take this normal force and I can plug it in. And this is going to get tricky when you start plugging in units. Make sure that you don't confuse the units of newtons with the normal force. So this mu k is going to be 45.0 newtons divided by mass times gravity times cosine theta. And I have all these numbers. 45 newtons divided by the mass of 62 kilograms, right there, times gravity's acceleration, 9.8 meters per second squared, times the cosine of the angle of 25 degrees. And I plug those all into my calculator, which you should always do. Anytime I talk about doing calculations, plug these numbers in. Make sure you're getting what I'm getting. And we get that the coefficient of kinetic friction is 0.08. And that's just a simple example of how we might apply friction in solving a problem.